are they don't even realize what the commandments say. They don't even go back and you don't believe in salvation. How do you not know why? You know what I mean? Like, how do you not connect?
Yeah, the second commandment says no idols.
No idols.
And even
well,
if you,
they don't read the book anyway. They go to church, but they don't read it anyway.
Nah, because they did. Yeah, they just, that's just that talk.
You understand? Don't read it. And you know, instead of just listening to somebody give tell you something, they go with that. That's about what somebody told you. Instead of doing a dig for it yourself.
It that's too much work. You have to change. You know, and that's a crazy problem. Is change, you know.
Oops.
So, yeah.
They accept tradition over truth.
That's in the Bible. Yeah. That was supposed to happen.
That tells you they're retarded because
yeah, you can quote that prophecy. You can put that on a billboard.
I'm sure I stole that from somebody.
I mean, even so. Somebody needs to hear it. You know?
Yeah, yeah.
It tells you they're retarded because they can't read for themselves. They got to think somebody else reads for them. That's the only time they mention the Bible is when the pastor preaches. That's like elementary.
That's what we always tell people, man. You got to read for yourself. Just go home with your Bible and read.
So free.
Just watch videos.
They accept comfort over change, you know. None of the people, the prophets in the Bible, were comfortable. You know what I mean? Like they were moving and doing unto the covenant. Yeah. What the Most High called them.
Shit, Jake killed the prophets. They come on straight. They got offended. They said they cut Saul and Isaiah's head off. That's in Hebrews 11.
David killed two boys for talking to Benjamin for their insolence, for murdering Saul's brother. For murdering Saul's brother.
Justice.
They don't realize, like.
You ain't got no water ball?
Well, I need some too, man, boy.
I should have brought some, man.
No, I got some in the truck for everybody.
In the middle of fucking downtown. It's like a desert out this bitch.
It's hard to breathe down here.
This coffee got me choked as well. I'm like,
The market is a microchip they're planning on putting in everybody's hand and taking away money. You gotta have to use the chip to buy anything. Get on the code bus, you gotta swipe your chip.
There's always something.
It's in the Bible. It's prophesied in the Bible.
Oh,
the mark
yeah,
of the beast.
You already read that?
Hey, he's asking about the mark of the beast.
Huh?
He wants to know about the mark of the beast.
Oh, we can go into that.
13.
Yeah, I'll get it. You want to get it?
Hey, we got to go into both 13 and 14, because 14
yeah,
tells 14,
what? Because it tells you you got punishment for it.
Right. Listen, my man.
It is what essentially was going to happen. They're going to get rid of cash, right? There's going to be no more paper money. As soon as everything's going all digital. Already, if you buy anything on the internet, you know, by Amazon and eBay, it's all digital already. So soon, everything's going to be digital. You ain't going to be able to get on a CODA bus unless you got that microchip.
That's right.
You're not going to be able to get on a plane CODA bus. You ain't no EBT. If you want to get EBT, got to have a chip.
That's why they taking the money and giving you the cars.
Yes.
That's right. They're getting you ready. That's right. We're that close.
Because they perfecting the technology. They get closer and closer.
You see people's cats and dogs got a chip in. They've been doing this.
Yeah.
They've been doing it. But now the people's turn to get their chip.
Yep.
And their people already got it anyway. Like a lot of, in Texas, no, that's Mexico. The police of Argentina, the police got it already. Military in the foreign countries. There's a club over there in Spain that you can't get in. This club where the rich and famous go unless you got the chip because you get scanned when you go in. So it's already in play. Now, look, check this out. Brooke Shields was on one of those talk shows saying, I'm giving my kids the chip, and she was speaking highly of the chip. So they're already getting started getting people's minds on it. Right?
She got evil spirits on her.
Yeah, and look.
But why you say that for?
You can just see it. You can see them jumping off of.
Yeah, some shit like that. Yeah. They have Brooke Shields on there.
I used to
speaking
love her chip.
Highly
that,
of the chip.
That movie, the
she's
Blue Lagoon.
Bad girl. She's bad girl.
You know right, the Blue Lagoon?
Yeah. That's when she was a young little tenderoni.
Yeah.
But she was a young tenderoni then.
Okay. No, that was my favorite movie.
What that Statue of Liberty and that mean?
Yeah, that's the
chip. Oh, yeah, let's get to the chip. Well, the Statue of Liberty, that was made by Freemasons. And if you see this right here, that goes back to the ancient Roman sun god. Represents soul and victory. That's where they get Christmas from. On Christmas, on December 25th, in the ancient Romans worshiped the sun on December 25th. That's where Christmas comes from. It's nowhere in the Bible. That's the ancient pagan shit. We're gonna get to that mark of the beast. Go ahead,
but right now we're talking about the RFID chip.
Yeah.
You know about the RFID chips?
It's all right, bro.
Revelation 13:15. And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause death. As many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. And he causeth all, both small and great, rich and poor, free.
Yeah, even the bankers, the elite, everybody gonna get it. It's gonna be mandatory. Keep going.
Here we on the chip. This is a spiritual. Here we on the chip.
Something and they bounce.
Relevant is. Right. Something that's gonna help them, you know?
He asked about it and he didn't want to hear.
Mind dumb. Look at all them hoes.
We ain't surprised. Look at that. What'd you call? You call my women hoes?
Whores. Those are our queens.
My bag, man. My bag.
I'm offended by that.
I gotta respect them bitches. I mean, them,
my sisters. Those are my sisters.
You gotta respect them bitches. I mean, your sisters.
Them fucking whores.
Hey, fucking trifling ass whores.
They probably like licking each other's buttholes.
With the tinkling of their shoes and the mincing of their feet. Instead of a sweet smell, there shall be stank.
I got you a question.
What's up,
they doing over there?
Here, back.
That's them high heels. That gives you the impression that it's there.
They just
that mess up your back and everything.
High heels. Feet older should go back on.
I know women that had surgery on their feet from wearing high heels all the time.
So. You see the way the Chinese women do their feet? They wear them little ass shoes and it crushes their toes. And shit.
They do stuff with their feet too.
Yeah, that's, it just to look cute. It's not cute. Having deformed feet, yeah, that's not cute.
Spanish feet.
Revelation 13:16. Man. And he causeth all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in the right hand or in the forehead, and that no man might buy or sell, save that he had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast. What is the number of a man, and his number is 666.
Yeah, because they're going to put a microchip. Hell, they probably going to have two chips. Probably one in your hand and one in your brain.
Oh, a bitch. They got a bitch microchip in the hand and in the pussy, whatever, down there.
I've seen that. Because Google been, because you can get on Google right now and type in Google brain microchip. Just type that in, and you get all kind of results of Google themselves. And this is old news. This is going back a couple years, you know what I mean? Because they've been working on that microchip for your brain because they plan on connecting your brain to the internet so they can control you and everything. So they got some crazy, they're going to sell, it's going to look real attractive. Because they're going to have things, the microchip that's in your brain is going to give you super vision. You'll have bionic eyes. It might give you super strength even. Did you see it coming? Because they're merging man with machine. And they think they're going to live forever with that technology.
Yeah, there's another video of the black woman that got the chip planted in her uterus. And it's vibrating and making a ringing sound, and she can't sleep, and you know.
Oh, that was like a
big, fat, nasty bitch,
yeah,
wasn't it?
Yeah, big, fat black woman. Yep.
Who the hell, man?
You should open two goddamn legs, you stupid bitch. The scripture says you ain't supposed to cut yourself open for nothing, you know?
Yeah, I don't try. I mean, I might go to the hospital for a broken arm or bone or something, get a cast. You know what I mean?
You gotta go to Esau.
But you ain't cutting me open.
Right. Right.
You ain't going.
I went to buy a new brief, a new knee brace, man, down the street. And Esau, like, man, you gotta have surgery.
Yeah, nah.
Like, no. He was like, I strongly think you should think about that.
They enjoy that cutting you open.
I want to cut you open. I don't want your semen dropping me. You know what I'm saying? They do crazy shit in these hospitals.
Putting semen up in your womb.
It's a demonic ass
We was watching something with the dudes from this rap group Twisted. But they testified. They knew a doctor. Was it a dentist? They knew a dentist who would put his balls and shit on people's face while they was passed out asleep, jacking off on them.
No, they said they went in there just so he could do it to them.
Right.
Yeah, that's some weird, but they was telling the truth.
It
was just in the news. A doctor got caught jacking off on someone while they was passed out.
Yep.
They doing it to a woman or something. That was just a couple weeks ago.
He probably beat it up, yeah. I don't like that.
So you got me fucked up.
This place is on this way to fuck out.
It's like
an evil place.
It is an evil place.
Evil place, man.
I was just watching.
This is the Revelation 14 and 9. The consequences of receiving the mark. And the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of the Most High, Yahweh Bahashim, Yahweh Shah.
So who's the main worshiper to the beast? Because the beast represents the government, you know, Esau's system. Is a woman, the Israelite woman. She's going to be the first one to take that microchip. Because they going to say, you either get the microchip or you ain't going to get no food stamps, no EBT. So she going to take it. Our women, they going to take that chip. You know, might have a couple, you know, soldiers out, women, they might not take it.
Yeah, they going to stick it out.
They going to stick it out. They be like, oh, hell no, you ain't putting that shit in me.
But they already, before they went and got
but
that chip.
But most of these women, yeah, they going to take it, bro.
Yeah, before they got that chip, they already were starving and hungry.
Yep, they was already fucked up.
They already swiped the card, you know. The EBT card was off, you know. Her ATM card was off. Their cell phones was off. She can't call the niggas she done fucked over in the child support courts. Her whole world falling apart, you know.
They going to take that shit.
Right. The same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of the Most High, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation.
And
he
without
shall
mixture.
Be tormented.
So they gonna get that torment without mixture. You know, they going to be watered down. It's going to be 100% pure destruction.
Right, watered down.
And yeah, they going to be no watered down destruction. Either it's going to be a thorough destruction.
That's right. And he shall be tormented.
And there going to be none left, root nor branch. Mm-hmm. What scripture is that? I'm going to find that.
And he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels.
And what? In the presence of that. And that fire and brimstone is not hell. It's in the presence of the angels. Oh, that disproves hell, because they say fire and brimstone is hell. So you tell me there's angels in hell, right? There's the angels are in hell. I thought that was Satan down there.
Right.
Nah, that's talking about those missiles. When that nuclear fire starts raining down you fools. And the angels are going to be there guiding those missiles, making sure they hit their target. Because how many times have you heard about UFOs shutting down missile silos or starting missile silos up? Because you get on Google or whatever and just type in UFOs missile silos. And you get all kind of articles will pop up. Look it up.
And he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. And the smoke of their torment ascended up forever and ever.
Oh, see, the smoke of that torment ascended up. That's talking about the destruction. When America gets destroyed, that smoke, you know, it's going to ascend forever.
A long past time.
Well, you know, long, it ain't, I mean, it's actually going to be smoking forever and ever, but that's that poetic speech.
Right.
It's going to be a beautiful, marvelous destruction.
I mean, you know, America is a big-ass volcano, so it might.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, Old Faithful. Yeah. Hey, that could blow, too. I'm with that, too.
I'm with anything that's going to destroy.
Yeah, any destruction, anything that would make these people's faces drop, I'm with it.
Make them melt.
Because you want to see their countenance melt. Because you want to see the look before they go.
Yeah, I want to be going up into them chariots looking down like, damn!
Yeah, God
damn!
Yeah, you're like, damn!
Still going up, damn! Yeah. Like, damn!
You might feel bad for him for a second.
Not me.
Because you're going to be astonished at that destruction.
Hell yeah. Damn.
Damn! It's like you got knocked the fuck out to the extreme.
Told you to listen, fool.
Oh, yeah, I'm retarded. I know where
there
that's
you go.
At.
This is 2 Peter 3.
They going to loop that one. I'm retarded.
This is 2 Peter 3 and 7. But the heavens and the earth, which are now by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men.
That's what we got.
And check
here.
It out, man. He most high is preserving motherfuckers. I got a cousin that was shot on 4 different occasions. Each time he was shot 2, 3, 4 times, man.
Tupac.
And he's still alive. The one that last the dude I talked about got shot on 5th Avenue like about 2 months ago. He walking the streets again.
He probably freestyling.
He can't die, man.
That.
He can't die.
Can't die.
He can't die until the missiles hit, man.
He probably feels like that too. Like, yeah, he probably, they can't even get me.
He's a thug. He's one of those street niggas, man. All these times, all through these years, man, we just, oh, this time he gonna die. Got shot in the head this time. He's walked right back out on the streets, man.
That's crazy.
It's crazy, man. But I told my family, yeah, he's reserved. You know, he's been reserved.
Reserved for the missiles.
That's right, that's right.
Let me get to the precept.
No matter what happens to him, he ain't gonna make it, you know?
Malachi 4:1, for behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven, and all the proud, yea, all that do wickedly, shall be stubble. And the day that cometh shall burn them up, save the Lord of hosts, and I shall leave them neither root nor branch.
So ain't nothing gonna be in this room. Nothing.
It's gonna melt. They gonna melt these fools. Let me get that Zachariah.
What did Ezra see? He saw smoke and ashes. That's all he saw was smoke and ashes. Smoke and ashes. Let me finish this, Peter.
I'll go ahead, yeah. Man, it really is something crazy going on over here.
What the hell?
Ask him where they going.
Hey, what's going on? Y'all know what's going on down here? All these people? Is there a concert? Who's the concert? What's that? Fantasia. Is that gospel?
Oh, that's that American Idol girl?
Yeah.
Okay.
Fantasia.
You know, she won American Idol that one year. Yeah, she got like a real raspy voice.
Right. Okay. We marked all these fools.
She was like a gospel singer, wasn't she?
We marking all these fools. We came down here on the perfect day, man.
That's the Lord's blessing.
Yeah, that's right, that's right.
And they all fat as hell, too.
Hey, I watch y'all on YouTube.
Yeah.
Going to this concert about the Lord. Ohio, we came from Cleveland.
Oh, bro.
Hey, there's some brothers up in Cleveland.
Yeah, we got brothers up in Cleveland. Yeah, we got brothers in Cleveland.
Yeah, yeah.
I love y'all.
All right. Now get them digital,
sir. That was...
Copyright violation.
She's just trying to make her spirit in there. You know.
Well, maybe she...
She might be...
She watching shit. You don't know.
I watch y'all on YouTube.
Hey, so hold up. That tells you that she's seen some. That tells you that what?
That you're probably watching ISUPK or.
It don't matter because the word of the Most High don't go. It don't go out void. It's getting heard. Even brothers, they get discouraged. Like, ain't nobody even watching the videos. Why should I even continue? Hey, it's getting out there.
We don't get discouraged.
Yeah, I don't get. You know that. But you know, some brothers, they got, you know, weaker spirits. They might get discouraged.
Them type of brothers, we gotta lift them. We gotta help
them. Yeah, you gotta help out.
Esau.
Any of us, man. Any of us get weak or, you know, spirit is having trouble, man. Like mine now, you know.
I
live at home with women, man. They do this. It's all about our own. Hey, I'm about to go in the middle of the hood and just live by my damn self.
Because you out here, you're dealing with the world, you know what I'm saying? Because you around the world and shit all the time and dealing with these people. And you gotta stay focused, man. And stay focused on, keep your eye on the prize.
He said Fantasia and who?
Hamilton. Somebody else.
Hamilton.
Yeah. Devil.
Yeah, pretty much.
Devil. Hey, let me read this. Second Peter 3:7. But the heavens and the earth, which are now by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men. But beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing, that one day is with the Lord as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise,
right,
as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance.
Yeah, I mean, that's what, yeah, we, you know, we talk shit about people, but hey, still at the end of the day, we still pray for Israel, you know what I'm saying? Because we it's amazing when one of these people are waking out of their slumber, you know what I'm saying? What's that scripture say? That the angels in heaven rejoice over one sinner that repents? So that's an amazing thing, man. And you don't know who's going to wake up. The biggest jackass in the world, you think this dude got no hope. He might wake up, you know what I mean?
Look at these high heels.
They all wearing heels too.
Oh man, I saw this brother the other day, man. And the motherfucker was bleeding out his ass.
Oh my God.
And he was with some bitches, you know. They talking, they jocking him and shit and everything. but he was bleeding out of his asshole because he had the white pants on.
She probably
he was bleeding out of his
she probably hit him with the strap on.
Bitches like gay dude.
No,
the blood was increasing. You know how you see a dot at first. Cause I was worried because he kept bending over from him. You know, just bending over.
Like, that's gross.
Yeah.
You know, I actually seen this thing. They did a poll. It was in the news a few months back. I think it was on Drudge or something. And they did a poll on what kind of porn do different people watch. Mm-hmm. And they say most males watch straight porn. Or they like to watch women lesbian porn. But they said most women actually, they said women enjoy watching homosexual porn.
That's the shit.
Because they took a poll where women themselves told them what they like. You know, and not you could do it anonymously.
They like watching it with their boyfriends too.
So these women, you think, oh, they were women with no. No, these women are crazy.
There's this gay dude at my job. He fucking was a porn star, and he was selling videos to the girls at work, and they was watching them with their boyfriends.
That's just crazy.
That 6 foot girl with
it. She's just nasty. Mm-hmm. Amazon.
You look nasty, man. They on some other shit for real. And they down with anything. You go on back page, you just, because I go to back page just to be reading that shit under escort, and they be saying, fetishes, I welcome. You know, there's nothing I won't do. You know,
the reason why they do that is because we allow it. Yep. People allow it.
Yep. Look at this fool in his fucking yellow suit.
Participating.
Because you ain't supposed to be letting a woman just go out and do whatever she wants. I'm sorry, that's not the way it works. So you got to treat a woman like one of your children. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you go.
You are the man of the house. This is a saying called man of the house.
That's bad as hell.
Man of the house means you do what the hell I say or you walk.
That's
you know what I'm saying?
Total of 70,000 in that truck right now. Was a truck is so close.
Yeah, that was crazy. We had Dodge Ram too.
Them EPMs, look, he gonna be in the middle of the street. He gonna be stuck right there where it is.
And the 57 Chevy be rolling.
I need a truck like that go mud running.
Gotta see Fantasia.
Hey, what up, baby?
Gotta see Fantasia. Gotta see her.
And who the hell names their daughter Fantasia?
A fool.
Fantasy.
A fool. A fool.
At least that word actually means something. What about the name Sharkeisha? They're just making names up. These women just make names up. They'll name their child after like an ancient demon.
Shit. I know a woman named a kid. Hennessy?
Alizé? Yeah. Hennessy?
They name their bitch after a car, Porsche.
Porsche.
Lexus, Mercedes.
Yeah, Lexus, Mercedes. How you gonna name your baby after a car? Man, what the fuck is wrong with you?
Stupid.
You need this shit slapped out of you for that one. You need to push down a flight of steps.
You need one of them special Russian ICBM missiles. They saying them Russian missiles are sci-fi. They saying they're 40, 50 years in the future. They said the Russian missiles are literally in the future, some sci-fi type shit.
They got the top technology in the world.
We're gonna get bugged out, man. And they gonna put one on display just to bug us out. Watch.
Why you think Edward Snowden's in Russia?
It's a dude. Where my dude I told you about? Yeah. The tattoo on the back right here. Shorty!
What's up,
boys?
What you got going on out here?
Chilling, doing what we do.
Who's the devil?
I see you still talking to your friend.
Who said?
What's up? You remember what we do. right. What's my dude right here.
What's going on?
What's up, bro?
Hey, what up?
Your friend, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you still got that tattoo on your back, right?
Yeah, still got it.
I wish
it,
you
man.
Could show them, man.
How you, man? I'm ready.
Y'all going to see Fantasia?
We
out here talking about the scriptures, man.
Anthony Hamilton?
Yeah.
What is he, like gospel singers?
He
said, I don't give a damn about no Fantasia.
He's packing it in, that's all.
All right. Gospel? Like soul / gospel.
Yeah.
More soul.
Must be popular.
Yeah. A lot of people going tonight. What's been up, though, man?
It's crazy out here.
Oh, no, just, you know how it is.
How's the kids?
Grown and oh my goddamn man.
I'll go ahead.
That's your girl right there, boy.
She's getting it in. I mean, you know, our women have got lively spirits, man. That's how you can tell the difference between an Israelite woman and a heathen woman. Look at our women. They lively, crazy as hell, wicked as hell.
It looks like it just hurts to walk.
Oh, wow. She got it, though.
She got that wet.
Oh, shit. All right, let's stay focused.
I'm gonna go to back to that point you were saying that when Luke's here, we're gonna be like kind of scared.
Yeah, yeah.
Read that point right here. It's Revelation 11, and we start at 10.
How y'all doing?
Hey, talk to me when I'm sober.
What'd she say?
Talk to me when I'm sober, then I got you.
Revelation 11 and 10. And they that dwell upon, no wait, 11, and no, sorry. And 12, and they heard a great voice from heaven saying unto them, come up hither, and they ascended up to heaven in a cloud, and their enemies beheld them. And the same hour was there a great earthquake, because some nukes are going to shake the earth. You know what I'm saying? And the 10th part of the city fell, and the earthquake was slain of men 7,000, and the remnant, the elect, were affrighted, and gave glory to the God of heaven.
You ain't see that, I'm sorry.
I want y'all to see that tattoo.
What was it?
The tattoo of the Virgin Mary.
Oh, okay. Hey, all these Israelite women out here, boy. We done seen it all today. I mean, I'm a loss of words after seeing these women today, boy. That the cream of the crop done came out tonight. I gotta read that again.
We done the creme.
Because you said we did that Duck Street Thoroughbred just walked by. That's why I say you can tell the difference between an Israelite woman and a heathen woman easily. So you can't tell me that all people on the earth are the same.
Yeah.
There ain't no other women on earth that act like our women.
Yeah. She got a little spunk.
A little spunk. That's all she got.
I got a scripture.
With some wickedness.
I got a fire scripture for you.
Read that scripture. He wanted to get this out. Are you good? Slug, man. You know.
Here we go. Here
I didn't hear anybody.
Here we go.
Hey, you just, man, you shake your head after seeing this. Every year, and then that one woman, she's like, you gotta talk to me when I'm sober. She was, that's a SSBBW, man. She was getting it in, bro.
Right.
You know, she paid too. These women got, how did they get that? They got the good jobs. And they just clowns.
Or
you
just
yeah, they collecting social security.
Nah, they got good jobs.
And all their jobs is down here.
Yep.
Downtown.
I mean, they getting paid.
All around downtown.
They got nice cars, nice clothes, right. Nice everything.
And each floor would be a whole one business. You know? Well, each floor would be one business, man.
And we can't get no kind of good job.
And their business, they rent a whole floor for their business. And the next floor is some other corporation, and the next one, and going up, man, you know? I've been in the motherfuckers, that's how I know, because my kids' mom worked at the one right there. My kids.
Each building is like a whole city.
That's crazy, man. Here we go. This is Exodus 1, and I'm going to start at 15. And the king of Egypt spake to the Hebrew midwives, of which the name of the one was Shiphrah, and the name of the other, Puah. And he said, when ye do the office of a midwife to the Hebrew women, and see them upon the stool, if it be a son, then ye shall kill him, but if it be a daughter, then she shall live. But the midwives feared the Most High, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, and did not as the king of Egypt commanded them, but saved the men children alive.
Hey, right, we was talking earlier, because we will have some women, like, they ain't going to take the microchip. They're not going to take the mark of the beast.
No.
They might, you know.
There goes DB Thunder.
They might be dumb as hell, but.
Angel Michael will save his.
You know. They might get a couple things right here and there.
And the king of Egypt called for the midwives and said unto them, why have ye done this thing and have saved the men children alive? And the midwives said unto Pharaoh, because the Hebrew women are not as the Egyptian women, for they are lively.
Yeah, you know the Egyptian women, they just heathens. Egyptians are heathens. You know, you don't even want to be around no Egyptian woman. She, you know, and all kind of witchcraft, all weird ass spirit on them.
Right. For they are lively and are delivered ere the midwives come in unto them.
Yeah, our women got lively spirits,
lively
man.
Shit, you know.
These heathens ain't got no lively spirit. I was in the grocery store yesterday, seen these Ethiopians just looking weird as hell.
I seen a motherfucking Chinese bitch down here sitting in the middle of the sidewalk.
Just looking crazy as hell.
Bugged the fuck out.
Bugged out. Our women, man, they'll take up for the heathens, but I bet you they won't live like a heathen and do all that heathen shit. Well, actually they do, but you know what I mean. I bet you they ain't gonna go move to Africa.
Yeah, right. Well, polite ain't going either.
Hell no.
Polite too busy robbing his people here. Robbing Israel here.
They going, I ain't living in no hood.
Shit, I wish I can.
Really, yeah, really.
You know, I wish I can, you know?
Yeah, they'll take up for the heathens, but go tell them to live amongst the heathen.
Right.
Yeah, they don't have nothing to do with it then. Because nobody likes Somalians living around you.
They don't want to be around you anyway.
Hell no. And everybody knows Somalians stink. That's not even a secret.
So y'all want to and Creepyopians?
Yeah, Creepyopians.
Anyway.
Them people want it.
We are not African, folks.
Hell no.
We are Israelites. We are the biblical Israelites, not a nigga.
Uh-oh, got definitely quiet.
Or some corporate faggot.
I'm gonna talk shit about that point right there.
Fucking faggot ass. You can tell that nigga on the down low. He like his women. But
they got
like
money right there,
like
too.
Dick. Yeah, that's money right there.
That's money.
Right.
Hey, you got Jake and Columbus got money, bro. I mean, you said I live on the east side. That's where a lot of them live, is out east. There's nothing but, you know what I mean? There's, you know, pretty nice houses and stuff out there.
Nigga.
Jake got money out here.
Yeah, they shine. They shine.
They living good, man. They got, you know, they got their reward on this side.
When that chaos happened, I hope they in the middle of doing the same shit they doing when this shit starts, when it hits sudden, you know? When it hits sudden, these people gonna be out partying and having a good time. Not even thinking about the Lord, man. It's the last thing on Israel's mind is the Lord. It's the last thing.
And if they do, you know, if they do talk about the Lord, or if it's not, it's in word only.
Right.
That's a, you know, what's that scripture in Matthew 7? Many come saying, Lord, Lord. Oh, yeah, they worship. They worship that false image.
Right. Here we go. Here, let me get a scripture real quick. Let me get the perfect description of these people real quick. For this is Isaiah 29 and 13. Wherefore the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near, what? Wherefore the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near me with their mouth and with their lips do honor me, but have removed their heart far from me, and their fear toward me is taught by the precepts of men.
Yeah, precepts of men. Oh, we was talking about that earlier. Right, they follow traditions rather than truths. You know what I'm saying? Christmas, Easter, ain't nowhere in the Bible. That's the tradition of men. Ain't got nothing to do with the truth. Having women preachers ain't got nothing to do with the truth. Saying we gotta love everybody. Got nothing to do with, saying Jesus love everybody. So he came to save everybody. That ain't got nothing to do with the truth.
He came to save Barack Obama.
Yeah, Saint. Oh,
look at your boy.
Yeah, he smoked out. He might have psychological brain problems or some shit.
No, he's dancing.
Look at this right here. Look at that. She dressed as a cougar and everything.
Get sneak it in there, boy. That's a real cougar.
That's a real.
She's on the prowl, boy. She a purr. You can hear the purr. I mean, you can get that easy. Oh, there's your voice. I got this one. We was just talking about these bugged out Christians. This is Matthew 6 and 5. And when thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues and in the corners of the streets, that they may be seen of men. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward. But when thou prayest, enter into the closet, and when thou shut the door, pray to thy Father which is in secret, and thy Father which seeth in secret shall reward thee openly. That's all them Christians, they always like, everybody get together, we all gonna pray together. The scriptures say don't even do that. Pray in secret.
Pray together.
You can pray in your mind. They just want to pray so they can be seen. People think, oh, we righteous. Right. You go to church, pastor be like, everybody rise up. Just now say a prayer.
They all raise their hands to the sun god.
Yeah, they raise their hands to the sun god.
Now let us pass the plate.
That's the god they're serving, the sun god.
Yep, because those Christian churches are really just pagan temples.
Yep.
Y'all really work. They really worship Baal. The Lord of the Flies, Beelzebub.
They're a bunch of witches and devils.
They're a bunch of witches and devils. And a lot of the pastors, they know that they worship Baal. And then they knowingly deceiving you.
Y'all see that temple yet that was erected there?
So. Oh, the temple of Baal, the arch and all
the
that?
One over in Europe, somewhere, one in New York.
Yeah, they about to build them all over the place.
Yep.
Well, they already got them, though. Yep. But now they're being open with it.
Yeah. That's beautiful, though, because Satan should be starting to reveal them. These devils start to reveal themselves, what they really all about.
Where the IUIC guys? We keep seeing the IUIC. Oh, they ain't gonna come out here.
He was about to get off too, buddy.
Cause our camera died last week. We seen them.
And they wear that every day, all day, man.
They wear combat boots. And this one dude, he was walking around, from the IUIC. He had like artwork all up in his hair. That's crazy as hell, man. And he was the leader, walking around with a whistle. Like he was Major Payne or something. Don't touch the whistle.
Directing traffic.
Yeah, where you going to direct traffic? Crazy,
the most
man.
I say go to the highways and byways.
Make sure you take your whistle. You're going to blow the whistle.
That's crazy, man. That's crazy.
Jake is bugged out. And they quick to follow them clowns, too. That's good. If y'all want to go follow the Foot Clan, go follow them.
Yeah, they definitely for Fantasia.
Y'all going to see Fantasia?
Going to step on that, get a blessing. You don't want a blessing? Going to step on that, get a blessing. Going to step on that, get a blessing.
That's with the sword.
Why not? What?
You get it?
That's some devil, man.
What's that?
What? You serious?
That's your Lord.
That's your Lord and Savior. I'm gonna try. Hey, let me show you in the Bible just that the Lord don't look like this. So if the Lord don't look like this, this ain't him.
What's he look like?
You know? We're gonna read it for you. Listen, we're gonna read it for you.
Revelation.
That's blasphemy.
Show him what he looks like?
Yeah, you said.
Let me show you what he looks like.
Go ahead, read that scripture.
What is all this about? Revelation 1:14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
I said Jesus' hair. The one his real name is Yahweh Shai, not Jesus. Right. He said his hair is white like wool. Does that guy right there have white woolly hair?
So it's all about what he looks like now?
No, but that's a lie though. There's no truth in a lie.
Because John
looks like an American.
Listen. John seen the Lord, so why would he just now out of nowhere describe what he looks like for no reason?
He wanted you to know because they knew in the lack there'd be deceivers out there.
Been with for 3 years and now he all of a sudden this is what he looks like. That's stupid.
I don't know.
And the Bible says you ain't supposed to have long hair either. That's only something a woman would do. The Lord ain't look like a woman with long hair. You know what I'm saying?
He ain't have no
the scriptures specifically say, yeah, the Lord was a dark-skinned man with short hair, not long hair like a girl. So that's a deception.
As white as snow, and his eyes were a flame of fire, and his feet like unto fine brass, as if it burned in the furnace.
That's the best one I could find.
That pretty good.
They did this on the computer.
Yeah, the PlayStation.
Hey, this is what he looks like. That's the Lord, what he looks like right there.
A lot closer than that one.
Red eyes is from the wine he drank. He drank, you know.
Yeah,
to deal with these stressful ass crawled ass and roaches out here.
Yeah.
You got to drink a little something.
Otherwise, you go crazy.
You know, right. You got to sip on a little wine to deal with
his foolishness.
You know, deal with flies and gnats and.
Our people are foolish as hell, man.
You know, and snakes.
They're savages.
Yeah.
Our people are savages. Just like the scripture, they're wise to do evil, but to do good, they have no knowledge, none. The Lord himself said this is a... We teaching the Bible. It's all information. In the mark of the beast, soon they're going to put microchips in everybody. If you're going to buy anything, if you want to go to the store, buy some groceries, you got to have a microchip. There's going to be no more paper money. It's going to be all digital. It's almost all digital anyway. You want to get on Amazon, eBay, all digital, bro. Soon it's going to be 100% digital. They already trying to phase out cash. Even the CEO from PayPal, you know what PayPal is, right? The CEO of PayPal said in the future, He wants it to be so if you to use his service, you have to have a microchip in your brain.
Fuck that. That's what's coming.
That's why you gotta warn the people.
So we're doing, we're watching.
Washing the blood off our hands.
That's right, that's right.
Can't say we didn't tell nobody.
They ain't got no excuse now. They ain't got no excuse. Pastor Porkchop ain't going to nobody.
Hey, let's get that at Ezekiel 33.
Want to get Ezekiel 33? I mean Ezekiel right now.
For us the spirit.
Yeah.
He's about to go blow his trumpet.
Well, if I actually played an actual real trumpet now, I'd pass out. Yeah, it'll start at 33-1.
Whoa.
You want to read it? I can read it. You got it?
You see that little bitch over there?
The white girl going by? Yeah, she's kind of cute too.
That's Satan. It's a distraction.
Ezekiel
33:1. Again, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, speak to the children of thy people, and say unto them, When I bring the sword upon a land, if the people of the land take a man of their coast, and set him for their watchman, if when he seeth the sword come upon the land, he blow the trumpet and warn the people.
That's funny he said blow the trumpet. He just reads the scripture about blowing the trumpet, bro. You gonna tell me that's not spiritual?
Dude, just walk by with the trumpet.
Yeah, because we's talking about that spiritual trumpet, meaning our voices. Well, actually, you know, you gotta sound the alarm. We out here sounding the alarm. We know what's coming. We know that a microchip's coming. We know that martial law is coming. The race riots are coming. We know all these things.
She's gonna put the razor to her pants and cut her pants the fuck up. And whosoever heareth the sound of the trumpet and taketh not warning, if the sword come and take him away, his blood shall be upon his own head.
Right. So you gotta warn the people. Otherwise, you're gonna have blood on your hands. You know, you have to pay for that. If you know the destruction and evil is coming to our people, and if you don't warn them, you're gonna have to pay for that.
That's some wicked shit not warning somebody.
So that means once we tell you, that means you now know. Yeah. And if you don't warn people like we just warned you, you're gonna have to pay for that.
That's right.
Go ahead.
He heard the sound of the trumpet and took not warning. His blood shall be upon him, but he that taketh warning shall deliver his soul.
Yep.
But if the watchman see the sword come and blow not the trumpet, and the people be not warned, if the sword come and take any person from among them, he is taken away in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at the watchman's hand. You know?
The Lord ain't playing around with y'all, man.
That's right.
You gonna do this work, or you gonna get dealt with. The Lord's gonna deal with you. Yo, I got better shit to do. I gotta play my franchise on Madden.
The Cavs game is
yeah,
on.
Yeah, the Cavs. I guarantee the Cavs is on. Oh, Curry just came back.
Right. Did he though?
No, I don't even know. I know he got hurt.
Right.
Look at the
Oh, yeah, oh, woe is me.
That's bad right there.
Yeah, woe unto me. I just read that.
Woe unto me.
I can't.
And that's how I feel every day, man. Woe unto me. And then, man, only the Lord can, only Yahweh Hashem Yahushua can take us out of this truth, man. But ain't nothing these snakes and lizards can do to take us out of here. Because ain't nothing to fear out here.
Nah, man. You know right, let's get that. Ezekiel.
If you know the fear of the Lord.
Is that Ezekiel 5? Don't fear these people. They didn't speak. I think that five somewhere is equal.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Was it three?
I could be wrong. It's right there. It's another one in Jeremiah there.
Yep.
Hold on.
Jeremiah go in on Jake.
It's 3 and 8.
1 Corinthians 9:16. For though I preach the gospel, I have nothing to glory of, for necessity is laid upon me. Yea, woe is unto me if I preach not the gospel. Yeah, so if you don't teach this gospel, you're woe unto you.
We know too much, man. Not teaching this, man.
That's why people get bugged out. They see you act like, damn, I see you on the corner yelling and screaming and shit.
Hey, don't a mafia take your ass out because you want to leave?
Yeah.
They take you out because you know too much.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you know too much.
You know, because they got that from Most High will take you out. I gave you all this wisdom and you don't want to teach nobody this?
Because people can't even fathom, like, you actually do that? And like, I know too much. you can't keep that inside of you. You got to let it out. You know what I'm saying? You got to let that. If you know all this.
Leonard's little brother.
Who?
Leonard's little brother.
Right here at the bottom. Oh, hell no. Yeah, I knew it was something.
Leonard.
There's a little resemblance there. Oh,
hey, Leonard's bugged out now.
That's a druid right there.
Oh, yeah, that's my dude.
That's why I
told
you Facebook.
Go ahead. It's Ecclesiasticus of Sirach, 20 and 30. Wisdom that is hid and treasure that is hoarded up. What profit is in them both? Better is he that hideth his folly than a man that hideth his wisdom.
Oh, yeah, so you got all this wisdom, and you know how the world operates, and you know that how these devils are manipulating us. Hey, you supposed to tell people, man. If you know evil is coming and death and destruction is coming, you supposed to warn people.
Even if you don't, for some reason, like fear or whatever, you feel weird, you feel ashamed and shit, you feel all salty, you feel like, you feel like whoa, when you gave up the opportunity to teach you, you didn't do it. That's how it was.
I made that mistake a couple times. I had an opportunity to teach a couple people that my mind was somewhere.
You have a question?
And I thought about
you
it
regret
later.
It later.
Damn. But it's all right. We make up for it, though.
Yeah, yeah.
We make up for it.
At least we out here, you know what I'm saying, teaching.
That was the spirit that...
They didn't allow you to teach them.
There you go.
Yeah, everything happens for a reason, man. Everything is spiritual.
Here, I'm cutting some brothers to hell up the other day. The Lord didn't want me to talk to them because I couldn't find no scriptures at all, man.
Yeah, that's how... Sometimes the Lord
shut it
like
down.
That.
I was like, shut it down. These motherfuckers ain't nothing but heretics anyway.
Yep.
I'm out of here.
Sometimes, yeah, the spirit get on you, you're like, I can't even get this. That don't cast your pearls before swan sometimes.
There it is.
Ooh, you know what I mean?
Ooh, that's
all that is.
Swine, an unclean creature.
Yep. You know? And we got a lot of our people are they're unclean creatures. The Lord is liking them on the roaches and rats.
He calls them swine eaters.
Swines, yep.
Yep. He didn't call them swine eaters because eating swine is a good thing. He insulted people.
Yep.
You want me to read that Ezekiel?
Yeah, might as well keep going with it.
Okay, Ezekiel 3 and 8. Behold, I have made thy face strong against their faces, and thy forehead strong against their foreheads. And as an adamant harder than flint have I made thy forehead. Fear them not, neither be dismayed at their looks.
Oh yeah, so people they might be afraid to come out here and teach his word and say, oh, they might beat me up. Or man, you can't be afraid of these people, man. Most of them, they just selling wolf tickets anyway. A lot of times, yeah, they scared of you.
Oh, they be a rebellious house.
Yeah, because our people, man, they like to look, they talk a good game, you know.
Yeah. Well, man, we got people literally cussing us out in front of us, drooling and everything, man.
Yeah.
Drooling and everything. Like the dude that said, he say, when you ask him, what's your name?
Yeah.
That motherfucker was actually drooling, man. I was bugging out watching.
He was drooling.
You know, I couldn't believe it.
Hey, he had that actual, Satan himself was in that dude.
Yeah, sure was. Drooling,
he told us his name was Satan.
Yep, the dude was drooling too, that pulled his dick out, shaking his shit.
Oh, yep. So there's some heavy demons out here you got to deal with.
Yeah, let me read some more.
Why you just curse him out in the name of the Lord, man? You ain't nothing to be afraid of.
Moreover, he said unto me, son of man, all my words that I shall speak unto thee, receive in thy heart and hear with thine ears, and go get thee to them of the captivity unto the children of thy people, and speak unto them and tell them, thus saith the Lord power, whether they hear, whether they will hear, or whether they will forbear. So we don't give a damn if you don't want to hear this or not. Our job is just to give it to you anyway, because we like washing our hands. We like to be clean. We like the light. We wake up in the morning, we open shades, we let light in the house.
I got a scripture too. You ain't supposed to be afraid of these people. No matter how they might be look like some gangsters or you know, they got pistols or nah, they said they gonna kill you. So what? So you might get killed. Who cares? Exactly.
First angels to rise up.
Exactly.
One that get killed, you're going to be the first one raised up when the shit...
The Lord delayed a perfect example. What did they do to him?
Right.
They put him on a cross,
nailed
right through his hands, spear through his side.
Spit on him.
And he went out to the death, just cursing them out, telling them the truth. And they didn't accept the truth. They killed him. Look, Matthew 10 and 28. And fear not them which kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul, but rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell.
There you go, right there.
You better fear the maker. Now, we should get that Stephen scripture. Go ahead.
2 Maccabees 6:26. For the present time, I shall be delivered from the punishment of men. I'm going to start 25, sorry. And so they, through my hypocrisy, desire to leave a little time and a moment, to live a little time and a moment longer, should be deceived by me, and I get a stain to my old age, or make it abominable. But though, for the present time, I should be delivered from the punishment of men, then shall I not escape the hand of the Almighty, neither alive nor dead. Wherefore now, manfully changing this life, I will show myself such as one, as mine age, quiet.
Oh, that's just like your, that's just like the book of Jonah. He didn't want to go prophesy against Nineveh. You know, he got scared. So look what happened to him. He had to end up doing it anyway.
Some bizarre shit happened.
Yeah, so he got,
that's what I want to avoid, that bizarre shit.
You know, Moses, you mess around the Most High, have you living in a fish for 3 days.
Right.
And then you still got to go out and do it anyway.
Yeah, that's right. That's madness, bro.
The Most High do some crazy stuff, too. Most High is bugged out.
I ain't trying to go there, bro.
You do not want to tempt the Most High. You better just go ahead and do what he says. You better just go ahead and do it.
Right. Don't question it. Just do it with all your heart, bro.
Because you know how many people we done seen drop dead around us?
Right.
Man, we're running out of people to drop dead. I done see my stepbrother drop dead. My other best friends grew up, he's gone. He's dead. All kind of people I talked to that later drop dead shortly thereafter. I mean, you call that a coincidence if you want. I mean, I don't believe in coincidences. That's why I tell people I meet, like, you better be careful around me.
What did Batman say to, or the commissioner say? He was like,
oh,
he
don't
too late
it.
To believe in coincidences.
Yeah, you don't believe in coincidences. Yeah, good detective don't believe in coincidences. Yeah, that's what he said. Go ahead.
Isaiah 51:12.
He's trying to holler.
She got that holler. Go ahead.
I am he that comfort you. Who art thou that thou shouldest be afraid of a man that shall die? Who the son of man which shall be as grass? And forgetteth Yahweh thy maker, that has stretched forth the heavens and laid the foundations of the earth, and has fear continually every day because of the fear of the pressure, as if he were ready to destroy it. And where is the fury of the pressure?
That's why a lot of brothers don't go out and teach, because they got that fear of them. They afraid what people gonna think. They afraid, you know, they afraid, because Jake is all crazy looking. They afraid of Jake. They think Jake might beat him up or something, jump him or something. Hey, fuck him, man. Don't be afraid of these people. Look, we out here chilling. We've been doing this for years. We ain't afraid of these people. They ain't gonna do nothing. Exactly, yeah. It may make your day more interesting. This is fun to me. Coming out here is fun. It's like going on an adventure. You don't know what could happen.
Come fuck with us. You get a spiritual ass whooping.
Yep.
Come fuck with us.
And then, because if somebody does try to mess with you, what? They might just blindly walk out in the middle of the street for no reason. A gust of wind and hit them, they walk right into a coda bus. And that'd be the end of
this. Is Ephesians 6:19.
Oh, how many times have we seen scoffers ride by on skateboards and bikes, talking, then crash right into a pole, get broke? You see it all the time.
Ephesians 6:14, 19. and for me, that utterance may be given unto me, that I may open my mouth boldly.
Boldly.
Make known the mysteries of this gospel.
Yeah, yeah, right. We out here in all boldness to let these mysteries be known.
For which I am an ambassador in bonds, that therein I may speak boldly as I ought to speak.
Paul, yeah, Paul got locked up. Hey, Paul got executed teaching the word by the Emperor Nero. Most of the apostles got executed, crucified. Did they care? No. That was, for them, that was part of their glory.
They took it like a man.
They took it like a man. All because the Lord said, what? Ye shall also drink of this cup. You know what I mean? They set the example of how you're supposed to live. What did the Lord say? There's no better thing you can do than lay down your life for your friend. I'm going to look that up. Get the exact wordage on that.
Got it? So Philippians 1:21.
Oh, where'd my script go?
For to me, to live is mashiach, and to die is gain. But if I live in the flesh, that is the fruit of my labor, yet what shall I choose? I wot not. For I am in the strait betwixt two, having desire to depart and to be with mashiach, which is far better.
Oh, there you go. So we do get killed or whatever, die, drop dead. It's a lot better than being here. Being dead is more exciting.
This ain't living.
This ain't living. This is hell. This is hell out here. This is Hades.
How much money you got? What kind of good job you got? This ain't no goddamn living.
This is death. Living in death right now.
Your health fucked up.
The valley of the shadow of death. You know, right.
Your health fucked up.
What they call chains of darkness.
You know? Your life fucked up. Fuck is this living, man? This ain't living. Hell.
What's that? Tupac had that song. This ain't living. You heard that? Yeah, that's a good one. This ain't living. He had that one right. He got a lot wrong, but he got that one right.
You're taxed out your ass. How the hell is this living, man?
This ain't living. I'm gonna have to listen to that one.
I'm not.
He said I'm not. You're probably right. He gonna say something bad and I'm gonna get mad at him again. You know that's how Tupac always happens.
Yeah. They'll be on fire through the lyrics and then say something stupid.
And then you turn it off.
Like, I fucked your bitch.
Oh, fuck. All right. You know what's coming.
I'm gonna kill you, know.
I heard MC8 did an interview. He said that Tupac was going backwards. He was all confused. One minute he revolutionary, next minute he a gangster.
He about yo mama, and he was like, then you wonder why they call you a bitch.
I'm trying to get him such a side as rap, because they scared of cameras.
Yeah, they real timid. They ain't even out here in all boldness, you know what I mean? You supposed to be bold, man.
And they're not apt to teach.
They're just passing out literature. Got him. Ask him if you can have some of that litter.
I'll go ahead.
This is 1 Peter 2 and 19.
Jesus.
19.
It's my kinfolk. My fellow ginger.
Kinfolk.
Yeah, it's my kinfolk right there. The Appalachian Queen.
Your boy just mugging us.
Alright. He's building up the courage, bro. He getting it. He's thinking about it.
He's trying to recruit us.
He's like, should I do it? Get him on camera. Try to zoom in. Oh, he gone. That's one of them IUIC dudes. Go ahead, bring that out.
It's 1 Peter 2:19. But this is thankworthy if a man for conscience toward God endure grief, suffering wrongfully. What glory is it if when ye be buffeted for your faults, ye shall take it patiently? But if when ye do well and suffer for it, ye take it patiently, this is acceptable unto with God.
That's right.
For even here unto where ye called, because Mashiach also suffered for us, leaving us an example that ye should follow his steps.
That's right. Whatever we're going through, we just take it as a man.
Take it like a man. Don't be all a little, like a little bitch.
Actually, that's the time to get harder into the study and the word when you're going through difficult times, man.
The Lord don't like a little bitch. Oh, murmuring and, you know, complaining. Like Job, he took it like a man. Read the book of Job. That's,
oh, yeah, Job.
You want to learn how a good example. Job, he ain't complained, did he?
He was in the spirit.
He was in the spirit. And he caught more hell than anybody. He was getting tortured. He was getting tortured.
He had boils from his toes. He had boils all over his body, man. Open sores and shit, man.
And his wife said, just curse God and die.
What up?
He said, you sound like one of them foolish women. Hey, look, I got a scripture. John 15 and 13. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. So, right, you're supposed to put it, you know, you got to put it all in. You put it, you got to go all in.
All in.
You're going all in. It says, John 15 and 14, ye are my friends if you do whatsoever I command you. And what did the Lord command us to do? To go out on the highways and the byways. Teach his word.
Be teach about, correct.
You're supposed to be about the Father's business. This
teach
is the Father's
truth, 100.
Yeah, keeping it 100. Oh, did Jake love to say that? I keep it 100. No.
Don't keep it 100.
Yeah, well, nah, we keeping it 100, and y'all get mad when we... We the kings of the 100.
They keep it 100 bullshit.
Yeah, y'all ain't keeping 100 nothing. 100% wickedness.
Yeah, that's just a saying that they use.
Yeah. No, we actually keep it 100.
We keep it 110.
My mom's old ass told me I'm becoming a mason, bro.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, she's 78 years old, told me I'm becoming a mason. I ain't say nothing.
She's gonna be the order.
Like, mom, that might benefit you quite well.
And women can't be a real mason. They gotta be part of the Eastern Star.
Eastern
Star.
Yeah.
And then they tell you the Masons is racist as hell, because they got a separate lodge for so-called black people. You gotta be part of the Prince Hall Masonry.
What up?
The regular Freemasons, that's the only white people allowed in there.
Right, 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 right.
Still to this day.
Yeah, yeah.
Ain't nothing
changed. Still the same shit.
And the Scotties people.
Even with the fraternities, they got the all black fraternities.
Yeah.
And all white fraternities.
Yeah. More separation. They ain't separated under their wickedness, man.
But they'll accept that, but they won't accept the Lord's division. Mm-hmm. See? Fucking hypocrites.
You there. What's that saying? Addicted to love. I'm about to say, I almost started saying aborted love.
There goes your homie.
Yeah.
She ain't going there yet. She wasn't feeling good. She went to the bathroom.
I know.
She said she wasn't feeling good and she went to the bathroom.
He's on cloud 9 right now. She brought demons in there, man. One day the demons let them free. Most of the time the demons is on them, man. They just walk like zombies.
Yeah, after a while, yeah, man.
Have a deep conversation with you, and then they see you the
then
next
they be bugged out. Yeah. Like your boy Leonard.
Yeah.
Oh, Leonard gone. Yeah. He gone.
He's scared of the beard demon.
No, he's afraid of me now because I have a beard.
The beard demon.
We talked to him thousands of times. You know, well, maybe hundreds, I don't know.
Enough times.
And
for hours and hours.
And hours. And now all of a sudden he's afraid of me. He's bugged out of his goddamn mind. He actually ran from me. I went to chase him. I was like, give me a hug. Just to freak him out even more. He bugged out. He ran from me, bro. He took off running. That's the Most High. Bug you out, man. He will literally bug you out. And have you acting all crazy and shit. Is that
people
my girl?
Most people don't get it. They don't know what to do or how to think when this shit goes.
You know she can't drive.
Oh, no. I was watching a bus driver up yesterday on her cell phone.
Hitting the curb and everything.
I was watching a bus driver on her cell phone, man.
Man, you got to watch them Coda bus. They be boss hogging driving. If you get in the way, they'd just run you right off the road. It didn't used to be like that. Man, that Coda bus is driving crazy as hell now. They actually got all these women drivers. They can't drive. Sorry, you might look good, but you can't drive.
You can't drive with shit.
Hell no. You may fear your life on the Coda bus. And you know, they try to keep up the schedule. Boy, they have Florida pedals.
Oh, this bitch was driving the other day and the brakes went out.
Oh, shit. Oh. You know, they panicked.
She was like flying through stop signs, all kinds of shit. I was like, damn, I need to get off this bus.
Hey, that's how movie speed. Where that movie speed?
Sandra Bullock.
Oh, shit.
Yo, yeah, that's right. That's right. Speed.
Man, we got a heavy dose of the Judite woman today, boy. Man, I don't even know what to do after this one.
I got enough of them.
They still coming. We're gonna get more.
Fantasia.
Fantasia. She talk like a dude.
Hey, what's how y'all babies doing tonight?
Yeah, that her voice sounded like sandpaper.
I still know what she is, man.
She's on like the second or third season of American Idol. I remember watching that bullshit.
I know the name though.
I used to watch that back when I was with my baby's mom. We used to sit down together, watch American Idol.
Family night.
Who you think's gonna win? I don't know. Who you think's gonna win?
Drinking a little something.
Wow, so-and-so win.
Getting along all the time.
Smoking weed.
Relationship.
Oh, yeah.
Putting it in their hair.
That's funny shit.
And she's still watching it. Probably with another dude now. She got my replacement, you know what I mean?
I think so.
That's
good.
That's just garbage.
Oh, that shit's garbage.
You see your girl Kelly Clarkson?
Okay.
You seen Kelly Clarkson? She won the first one. That bitch is fat as fuck now. She look like she done swole up, bro. You seen her? Kelly Clarkson used to look good.
I can't even watch TV.
Now she is fat.
I ain't turned my TV on in like 5 months.
Hell yeah, I ain't got a TV. I got a computer to monitor.
That's the girl you fuck with, her twin family.
I tried to watch Game of Thrones last week. I got like 5 minutes into it and shut it off.
I did watch that. I like that show.
Somebody's leg and arm were right in front of
them. Fucking boring.
Hey, I know what you're saying. You're getting that spirit. It's all bullshit.
I cut her off.
How's that funny?
And she was always asking money from me.
The end of America is not at hand.
I found out this bitch giving that motherfucking devil all her money, man. Osteen, Joe Osteen. She was going to his church.
Hell. He knows she's retarded.
Yeah, asking me for money. I found out all that.
Why? Because she gave Joe all her money?
She was always giving him his money, her money, man.
Joe?
Yeah, man, he going to have a gruesome...
He's a Jake, too. He going to die horrible. He's going to die horrible.
Oh, you can't say that. Now you're going to hear they never hear the end of that. Joe Osteen's an Israelite?
Hell yeah, you're Jake.
Joseph's a prince. That's my nigga.
I heard Joe Osteen say you're not supposed to eat pork. What'd you say?
Joseph Prince. That's my dude. The Chase, the Asian dude.
The dude to be hitting people?
Nah.
Oh, no, that's the other dude. Now, he's a Jake, too. Yeah. Benny Hinn. Benny, he'll hit you with his coat, like, pow, he'll smack the shit out you with that coat, boy. He like, in the name of Jesus, pow!
I made fun of that nigga. What's it called? Joseph Prince. The Prince Joseph some shit. Remember that?
I don't know. I probably seen it, bro. I know I seen it, yeah. Cause he be jive talking, don't he?
I think he is.
I know you're talking about. He got a little short dude. He got short hair. I know. Yeah, I'm almost on a pre. Even that one bitch, that old whore. She's a Jake. What's that old Joyce? Yeah. Joyce, yeah. That shit look like one of my aunts or something.
I used to. This is fucked up. I don't know.
Joyce, what's your last name? Joyce Meyer.
I used to watch that all.
You know that old bitch gotta be a.
Oh, the lesbian. Yeah.
She's just a no good.
Yeah, old girl.
Just an old whore.
She always used to talk about being happy, never being sad, never being. And it's this white dude. He's a Jake. I forgot his name. He's always talking about money and shit.
That's all they all talk about.
Rob Parsley, you got plant your seed.
You know Bob Parsley's an Israelite. Ain't no doubt in that one. He jive talk more than me.
I used to watch that motherfucker like, wow, this is interesting.
He be like, you gotta sow your seed of faith, brothers and sisters.
You ain't never send no money into him.
Now he try to go hard on the Freemasons and shit. Like he ain't a Freemason.
Right.
He be talking about the Illuminati. Cause you know people waking up to shit. So you gotta feed the people. If you don't give them something, they gonna leave.
He's trying to cover some of his tracks.
Yeah, you gotta keep them in there. Yeah. You can't keep them in the seats if you ain't.
You're on that bus. You're on the two-man truck.
Oh, it might be.
That'd be crazy.
That's what we work for. Yeah, wouldn't it be crazy? That would be the spirit of the Lord chasing that.
Daryl! Was that your cousin? Like, he still work there?
Yeah, he still.
They waved at us.
I ain't heard from Daryl in months.
Nah, he did something, hit me up on Facebook. Watch, you know, because I'm keeping contact with the friends and family on there. Well, now people gonna be searching
busted. For loved ones.
Well, because you don't want nobody to know you on there. Because then you got the fucking haters, they try to go through your shit.
DDA.
I don't have a phone, that's how I contact people. I can't afford a phone bill.
I want to get rid of mine, but I can't. I need this.
You make calls on Facebook.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, for free.
That's why I use that internet.
It's kind of janky, though, but yeah. Or you can use text-free on your Android. That's what I use, text-free. Broke piece of shit.
It's your vibe. 14 to 14. Then Yahweh said unto me, prophesy lies in my name. In my name, and I sent them not, neither have I commanded them, neither spake unto them. They prophesy unto you a false vision and divination, and a thing of naught, the deceit of their heart. Therefore, thus saith Yahweh concerning the prophets that prophesy in my name, and I sent them not.
The Lord ain't sending all these creatures and shit. Go ahead.
Yet they say, sword and famine shall not be in this land. By sword and famine shall those prophets be consumed.
Yeah, everything's gonna be good. You're gonna, the Lord Jesus is gonna come down. He's gonna heal everybody. Well, nah, yeah, he's gonna heal you with the sword. You'll be healed when you come back in the reincarnation in the kingdom.
Purge.
Yeah, right. There's a great purge coming. That's the perfect word, the great purge.
Come back as children of the prophets.
Yep.
Righteous men that know the law. It's gonna be perfect.
8:10.
All I know is time is short.
If the people to whom they prophesied shall be cast in the streets of Jerusalem because of the famine and the sword, and they shall have none to bury them, them, their wives, nor their sons, nor their daughters, for I will pour their wickedness upon them.
Yeah, you're gonna pour their wickedness because you did it to yourself, you know what I mean? That says the thing that same thing as what that Isaiah we read earlier. Was Isaiah 3. Woe unto them, they have rewarded wickedness unto themselves. Whatever how it goes. We just read it earlier. Isaiah 3. Woe unto the wicked. How's that go?
They were told they were born, but instead they scoffed or just ignored it. And they going, kept it stuck. That's going to be an awful feeling, man. That's a feeling I don't want to have. I don't want to experience that feeling of shame. That's a horrible feeling, man. To know you fucked up and be confronted with it? Oh, shit.
That's why people get offended so bad, because they know they're evil as hell. But if you had any sense, you would listen, though. So IUIC ain't come out today. That we didn't get a chance to get them on camera yet. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, they probably still coming.
Yeah. Well, they come out after the buses stop running.
And they do too.
It's Nick Spark down there at the concert, man, waiting for them to come out.
They probably in the concert.
Yeah, because Nate loves to capitalize. Every time there's a big event, he got to be there so he can get his shine on. He's just a poverty pimp, bro. That's all he is.
That's Nate's click.
Yeah, Nate, that dude. They're all cops. Them dudes are just zombies. They're like, he's like the. He's like a David Koresh type figure, like Jim Jones. You know, everybody sipping on that Kool-Aid. They just followed their great leader, without question. That's what you. That's what in them fanatical cults. We know everybody in their cult, because cult means worship. We're in a cult, but we're the righteous cult, right? Because cult means worship. Shit, but they all. You can see that dead look in their eyes. They just zombies. They believe whatever the leader tells them. It ain't gotta add no scriptural proof, nothing. You know, just whatever the great leader says, that's what they do. Don't worry about what the Lord said. Just listen to Nate.
Yeah.
And then he makes fun of the name of the Lord and everything.
Made a video.
Yeah, made a whole video saying you can call the Lord Yo Play Yogurt if you want.
Whole fucking video.
That's crazy as hell.
That's a crazy
video. Because I don't yet. You can't be watching all these different Israelite groups out there. The only group that got any truth is Great Millstone. That is it. There might be a couple of scragglers out there who got, you know, that doing the right thing.
Who?
ETA.
Who's that?
The Jersey. I don't think they like part of GMF, but they teach the same thing.
Oh, yeah?
The GTA, you know, tow truck.
Oh, yeah, that's right, yeah. He's always down there with the elders in front of him.
Oh, for real?
He's always down there.
DTA?
Yeah. Dark skinned brother.
I probably seen him.
Cool as hell.
All I watch is Great Millstone.
Here you go. This is Ezekiel 13:1. And the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, prophesy against the prophets of Israel that prophesy, and say thou unto them that prophesy out of their own hearts, Hear ye the word of the Lord. Thus saith the Lord power, Woe unto the foolish prophets that follow their own spirit and have seen nothing. O Israel, thy prophets are like the foxes in the deserts. Ye have not gone up into the gaps.
Little sneaky little bastard, sly as a fox.
Neither made up the hedges for the house of Israel to stand in the battle in the day of the Lord.
Hey, you know, that's the same thing as scripture you just read. How same these people, all they do is follow what's in their heart, tell you to follow your heart. They tell you to follow everything except for the word itself, you know?
Yeah, except the truth.
Scripture is that was
awesome.
That was
Israel 13:1, down to 5.
Follow your heart.
You can keep going, though, because I'm going to keep going. Thus said the Lord power, Woe unto the foolish prophets that follow their own spirit and have seen nothing. Thy prophets are like the foxes in the deserts. Ye have not gone up into the gaps, neither made up the hedge for the house of Israel to stand in the battle in the day of the Lord.
They prepared talking about building schools and shit, going to Ghana. Mm-hmm.
And their leader walks around with a whistle. What else do I need to say?
Right.
Oh, blow the whistle.
Well, he gonna blow the whistle and everybody.
Yeah, like what the fuck is
that? Start attention. What are you, dogs? You respond to whistles?
Dogs, give me 20.
Come here, boy. Wait a minute. The Lord do call them dumb dogs in Ezekiel.
We read that one earlier.
They really did come out after the buses are done.
They have seen vanity and living lying divination, saying, The Lord saith, and the Lord hath not sent them, and they have made others to hope that they will confirm the word. Have ye not seen a vain vision, and have ye not spoken a lying divination? Whereas ye say, The Lord saith it, albeit I have not spoken.
That's funny you say that, why those guys come out. Because they're got lying divinations.
I'm going to have to find it.
When they saying that they going to build universities and supermarkets, they going to build a Black Wall Street. You must be out your mind. They trying to build, the Lord's about to throw
it
down.
About to tear this shit up.
They trying to build it up when the Lord's about to throw it all down and just turn this country into a pile of ashes.
The scripture say they are all dumb dogs that lie.
I mean, did not the scripture say this is not your rest?
Yes.
Because they trying to build the kingdom of heaven up in the middle of Satan's kingdom. That don't make no sense. You must be retarded. Right. People are dumb with some FRNs. So they're looking for vainglory is what they're looking for.
The dude who watched that video about how they built up that little school, whatever that was.
That little bullshit.
Yeah, the dude was like, see, we got Israel's visual, and we like that visual. And then he didn't know he cut himself up.
Visuals, that's the idolatry.
Yeah, you gotta see it.
Visual, that's what the word idol means. Idol. It actually comes from the Greek word for to see.
Here you go.
But what they see, what's pleasing to the eye. Oh, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. The love of the world is the lust of the flesh, right?
That's
the pride
right.
of life.
That's right.
Because, you know, they lust after what they can see and what they can touch and what the visuals.
This is Isaiah 56:10. His watchmen are blind. They are all ignorant.
Ignorant. I mean, they have no knowledge.
They are all dumb dogs.
Dumb, they're ignoramuses, dumb dogs.
They cannot bark, sleeping, lying down, loving to slumber.
And hey. I ain't never even seen them talking to nobody. Nobody want to talk.
Nah, they handing out flyers, man.
Handing out flyers.
They can't bark the dog, but the barks and warrants. Mm-hmm.
Yep, when you're in the house chilling, watching our dog outside on the leash.
Be loud as hell. Be like, yep. Shut up.
Going crazy.
He's going so crazy. He's like, long lay out here.
He's barking. He's barking.
And the dogs are retarded as hell, and they got more sense than them.
Yay, they are greedy dogs, which can never have enough. And they are shepherds that cannot understand. They all look to their own way, every one for his own gain from his quarter.
Now, that's Nathaniel, because really, at the end of the day, he's not really trying to build up Israel. He's all out for himself so he can get that vainglory. He can get that money. He's all, it's all about, at the end of the day, all these people that's running all these churches and Israelite groups, it's all for the benefit of themselves so they can get paid. It's a hustle. That's all it is. It's a hustle.
The real motherfucking soldier will have a fucking pit bull.
They got their dogs all trimmed up and shit.
You ain't gonna see me walking down the street with a goddamn
come ye, say they, I will fetch wine, and we will fill ourselves with strong drink, and tomorrow shall be as this day, and much more abundant. So, you know.
They think they gonna live in abundance.
Yeah, yeah.
Talking about that Black Wall Street.
That's their objective, is to live fat, man.
See, all they care about is money. The Lord said, lay up not for yourselves treasures on the earth, but lay up treasures in heaven. Yeah. Right. And what else did he say? He said, whose image is on this penny? It's the Caesar's image. He said, render unto Caesar that which is Caesar's. Render unto the Lord that which is the Lord's. This money you got in your pocket, then fuck this money, man. Money ain't shit. The real riches is the truth. That's it. The hell with all this whole physical world, man. Hey, I'm going to get that scripture. Let me get this Philippians real quick. The people that chase after the flesh, man, that's a vain thing.
Hebrews 13.
The Lord said, he said the foxes have their holes and the birds have their nests. The Son of Man have nowhere to lay his head. Did it sound like he cared about building up the community?
Right. Hebrews 13 and 14. For we have no continuous city, but we seek one to come.
That motherfucker. That one to come is the kingdom that was promised to us. That motherfucker got straight through on him.
That's a foul spirit. Oh, shit. Damn. He a real
look at him, all big, fat, and sloppy. He probably got big money.
You know, he got money.
Pockets is deep.
A lot of these Jakes, they living good out here, man. Yeah. That's
he
why they so comfortable.
Ordered that bitch off Backpage.
Yeah, that's why he rent some out about people. Because actually, they do advertise that they'll do that for you come, you know.
Escort.
Escort, yeah.
There's so many Jakes in Columbus, you know.
Escort.
Yeah, they get paid good money, man.
The scripture says when this shit happened, man, we're going to know who are, the Most High said, you're going to know who his prophets are, who the chosen are. It's going to be a big difference. Them motherfuckers ain't going to have no motherfucking answers. They'll be catching fucking hell.
What's the one he says, I have no confidence in the flesh? I know it's in Philippians. See, I got no confidence in flesh. I'm all coughing and shit. Weak ass bodies, man. Fuck the flesh.
Ghana. I thought that Africans was an Israelite.
Yeah, Ghana, though. That's Jake's down there.
Oh, hell yeah. They got some beautiful women, too. Ghana, yeah. I'll be loving them Ghana women.
Yeah, that's one of the most beautiful women I ever saw was from Ghana. She was from Ghana, and she came here to see her brother, but she was living in Europe then, though.
Oh, they even said, back in the day, you know, that old, back when that Timbuktu was still a legend, they didn't know if it actually existed. They said the women of Timbuktu were fabled throughout the world. They said they had the most beautiful women in the world.
Yeah,
well, you know that. They weren't no heathens. They ain't no, I'm not attracted to heathen women, really. I mean, maybe you might see, but they probably a Jake if they are looking good and shit. Cause them some of the heathen women got big ass foreheads and shit. We all got rat eyes. Yeah, big. I mean, the Lord just cursed them. You know what I'm saying?
They don't know they ugly though.
Yeah.
They don't.
But that's just the heathen though. I mean, what are they supposed to do? Philippians 3. I knew it was in Philippians. And now I lost my Philippians. Let me get it.
3 and 4.
Yeah. Oh, you got it. I think there's more to it though than just 4. Go ahead.
I'm sort of three though. For we are, this is Philippians 3:3. For we are the circumcision which worship Yahweh, worship Yahweh Shai in the spirit, and rejoice in the anointed Yahweh Shai, and have no confidence in the flesh.
We have no confidence in the flesh. But that's salty. Yeah, that ain't salty. Yeah, dude.
Though I might also have confidence in the flesh, if any other man thinketh that he hath whereof he might trust in the flesh, I more, circumcised the eighth day of the stock of Israel.
Oh, see, that's that thing too, because that's all Nathaniel talk about, what, the flesh. All he talked about, keep the law, keep the law, keep the law, keep the law. He didn't never mention the word faith or hope, salvation. Just the law.
Shit, that's what he said. The first, how to, like the video, how to start it, he read James, said, faith without works is dead. So he said, oh, we got to build up the nation ourselves, whatever. Because faith without works is dead. And you can't, bitch ass,
that's
can't
sad,
wait
bro.
For the Lord to come. Like, you know what I'm saying?
That's just, that's pathetic, man. Nation. That's just the least spiritual as you can get. Hey, keep going with that. There's more juice in there.
Circumcised the eighth day of the stock of Israel, the tribe of Benjamin, and Hebrew of the Hebrews, as touching the law.
Oh, yeah. So what if somebody went up and came in that group and they had like a tattoo or something? I guess they would get turned away because they broke the law, right? Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because you ain't saved by the law. Ain't nobody keep the law perfect anyway. So I guess all Nathaniel's followers, all their clothes are made out of the same material too, right? Hell no, they wearing combat boots. Dude got a whistle. A whistle. A fucking whistle.
Right? That's a vain shit.
That's vanity. Didn't they be all going to attention like Esau's army and shit?
I wish they were just doing like that. Don't worry. That's what I'm saying.
Concerning zeal, persecuting the church, touching the righteousness which is in the law blameless. Oops, that's my place.
Yep.
But what things were gained to me, those I count loss for.
Keep going with that. There's more to it.
Yea, doubtless, and I count all things but loss for the excellency of the knowledge of Yahweh Shai, my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things, and do count them but dung, that I may win Yamashiach.
Yeah, it counted as dung, as shit. So the main thing that matters is doing the work, having faith, and that's it. The Lord said, whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved, right? That's it. That's all there is to it. Oh, but you got to keep the law perfectly.
We showing our faith by coming out here doing this work.
See, right, because the law says you got to kill faggots. If you don't do that, then you're breaking the law. You know what I'm saying?
But you got to get paid every single day.
Oh, yeah, you got to keep the whole law perfect.
Before the sun goes down. Yeah.
I mean, there's a lot of laws in there, you know.
What the fuck are they doing? They're just walking back and forth.
Some jobs you got to wait till a month, a little bit over a month before you get their first check, man.
The government job, mm-hmm. You get paid once a month, or sometimes twice a month.
When I had a job, I got paid two weeks.
That's a lot of days. That's 30 days.
Not coming over here.
31 days a month, man. You can only get two checks, man. That's crazy, man.
Cause you don't even know if you're going to be here tomorrow or not.
That's fucked up. That's the free labor the job got then.
Yeah.
And it's the corporations that's supposed to be paying the taxes.
They don't pay shit.
Yeah. You don't tax somebody's wages. You tax the income from the corporation. You don't tax
the only thing you're really supposed to tax is the goods.
That's fucked up, man. That's a fucked up.
Because really the only tax there was in the beginning was the tax that you gave to the priesthood, you know. Which isn't that the tax, it's a tithe.
Tithes.
You supposed to, that was it. You give a tenth, and then if you want to give some charity, that's on you, you know? Help the poor out, feed the poor, you know, help out homeless people, help out the fatherless, you know what I'm saying? That's what's supposed to be about. If you see, because we do that all the time, you see, we don't be boasting about shit, though. If I got a little change and I can see someone sincere and need help in the spirit, I ain't got much to give, but I might give you a little something. You know what I mean? But a lot of people, they out here scamming, begging for money. You got to know the difference.
Yeah, they be out here all day long.
Yeah, all day long getting paid.
Man, you got a dollar. You got a dollar so I can catch you, bro.
Hey, to and fro.
Don't ask me. He was over there talking to them.
Who the hell
didn't say a word to us, but he said something to them.
Well, we only down here because we got to be teaching, but who the hell would want to hang out here all day? This is not a fun. It's fun to hang out if you teach them the word, but what else? What is there to do down here? IUIC is bugged out. That's funny how you know damn well they're not even walking this way ever again. And not after last week. They came by, they walked by the lion's den and got bit by a lion.
I hate some fake ass folks.
Really, they are fake as hell. And we was cool to them at first until, you know. Fuck them, man. We ain't worried about them dudes.
Fake as fuck.
But they just lost souls. They don't know what's going on. They think they right in their mind, you know what I mean? They just under that hypnotic spell of Nate. He got them in a trance. They don't have their own minds.
All wearing the same shit. Israel like to be different, man. They wear their own style.
Yeah,
shit.
I got my own style. You get, even the rappers used to say you gotta become original with your shit. Yeah, really, man. And that wearing purple like that is proud. That's what some shit Prince did. Go ahead.
Yes. Because you're talking about the fake brothers. Alright, so it's Romans 12:9. Let love be without dissimulation. Abhor that which is evil, cleave to that which is good. Be kindly affectionate one to another with brotherly love and honor, preferring one another, not slothful in business, fervent in spirit, serving the Lord, rejoicing in hope, patient in tribulation, continually instant in prayer, distributing to the necessity of saints, given to hospitality.
Yeah, because you're right. You're supposed to be brotherly, man. And a lot of these dudes, they ain't really brotherly. They talk a game, but they ain't brotherly. Hell no. I'd be excited to see somebody else teaching the Bible, you know? Like, oh, what's up with y'all? What y'all doing out here? I'll be ready to get it in. Huh? The simulation? I can look it up. I didn't bring the dictionary. I don't carry around this 500-pound dictionary for nothing. People, every time someone pick up my book bag, they be like, God damn, what you got in there? Because I take my Bible and dictionary everywhere I go, you know? I'm
trying to.
You said dissimulation? But you never know where you're going to get caught somewhere. You might need somewhere to study. You get caught out there, just bored out your mind, man. You got some books to read. That's why it's good to download all kind of PDFs on your phone and shit, you know? You might get stuck without the internet.
That's comfortable. The internet gonna be shut down, ain't coming
back home. Yep. Yeah, ain't gonna be no electricity, mm-hmm. Let alone Wi-Fi, shit.
We're gonna have to need something to read, you know?
These people gonna lose their damn minds on that day.
We're gonna be bunkered in somewhere, wherever we're gonna have us, man. We're gonna just be reading.
Yep, that's why you gotta have them Bibles. That's why the Bibles and the Lord made it so the Bible is the number one selling book in the world. There's more Bibles in existence than any other book. And there's nothing you scoffers can do about that one.
Yeah, we're gonna be bumping in when this shit throw down, man.
That's how you know it's
digging for that game, man. Digging for prayer. We're gonna be stuck in prayer, man. You better be. Because we're gonna be witnessing this madness gonna come, man.
Yep.
Bloodshed. People don't understand the famine, man, was coming, man. They don't understand that because they never experienced it, man.
They've never experienced because they've been living fat their whole life.
Yep. Eating everything and anything. Just eating.
See, you know the old timers used to tell us stories. Well, back in the 1930s, boy, we had no food. We was eating dandelions. And you ain't believe them. Like, my dad told me he grew up and they had no food. He was eating dandelions. I never believed him, but I think he was telling the truth.
Right.
That was poor as hell.
Right.
Now all people living fat. Mm-hmm. Got EBT. There weren't no EBT cards back in the day. That's some new shit. Oh, go read that.
Romans 12 and 9. Let love be without dissimulation. Abhor that which is evil, cleave to that which is good.
Yeah, I was going to dissimulate. It means to make dissimilar or unalike, to cause, to undergo dissimulation, to become dissimilar. I got to look up dissimilar. Hold up. Dissimilar. Where's it at? Is it even in here? Yeah, that's right. No, I got it. Dissimulation, the act or process or making becoming dissimilar. 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 It don't have a definition. Oh, it means different. Unlike. They don't really go into it. You probably have to look at the etymology. You go, you know, to get it. That's surprising. Usually this dictionary is pretty good. It didn't really go deep on that one at all. It didn't even show the Latin. That's unusual. See that crossover? Hey, you see those missiles of the Lord drop?
That's our conversation.
Yeah. Hey, but yeah, you see that? You see that biggest get attacked by the wild pack of dogs?
Oh, y'all seen that shit? The Edomites, it was in like Thailand or some shit.
And oh, they moved.
Beat the fuck out of the whole family. Kicked the shit out of the old bitch.
Oh, yeah, I seen that. That was beautiful.
And all of them just laid on the floor all together.
Wow.
And wasn't it for adultery or something? I can't remember.
Oh, no. Hey, I'm saying,
it was just. Oh, did you see the people, they said it was the Mexican cartels killed people?